education.
Will be given by the mayor. You put that on there?
I did.
I saw it. With the sister, you're supposed to skip over the chair. Okay, but everybody rise and join me for the.
Father God, we thank you for the day. We thank you for bringing us together. We do all things to be able to glorify you, that the will of the community, that we all are guided by your wisdom and your will and the will of the citizens of the city of Odessa. Also, Father God, I ask you to intervene to make sure that our chairs are no longer swiped, removed, replaced, or adjusted in height. Father God, we ask all of these in your Son, our Savior, that glorifies us all. And all God said to respond by saying,
Amen.
You may be seated. We're going to be the pledges. You have pledge of allegiance and text of it by Councilman Mata.
Can you join me in the pledges? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Okay, we're going to go into public hearing. Item number 4, open public hearing on tax increase for fiscal year 2023-2024. Mr. Bowles.
Good afternoon, Mr. Mayor and City Council.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
A tax rate of 0.483791 per $100 valuation has been proposed by the governing body of the City of Odessa. The proposed rate is 0.483791. The known revenue tax rate is 0.47371. The voter approval tax rate is 0.522978. The no new revenue tax rate is the tax rate for the 2023 tax year that will raise the same amount of property tax revenue for the City of Odessa from the same properties in both the 22 tax year and the 23 tax year. The voter approval tax rate is the highest tax rate that the City of Odessa may adopt without holding an election to seek voter approval of the rate. The proposed tax rate is greater than the no new revenue tax rate. This means that the City of Odessa is proposing to increase property taxes for the 2023 tax year. Tax Code Chapter 26, Assessment Section 26.06 requires that the public hearing on the tax increase may not be held before the fifth day after the date the notice of the public hearing is given. As required, the notice of the public hearing was published in the Odessa American on Saturday, September 16th, 2023, as well as on the homepage of the City of Odessa website. It has been posted since that date the notice was given and will remain until the public hearing is concluded. The posted notice was on the City's website continuously for at least 7 days immediately before the public hearing and at least 7 days before the vote proposing an increase in the tax rate. The proposed tax rate, however, is not greater than the voter approval rate. As a result, City of Odessa is not required to hold an election at which voters may accept or reject the proposed tax rate. However, community members may express their support for or opposition to the proposed tax rate during this public hearing. If no one has any questions for me.
Captain?
Good.
Okay. So nobody filled out a card to be able to speak on this, right?
No.
So all we have to do is entertain a motion.
So can I clarify a couple of things, just for the record?
Take it slow.
Okay.
And speak softly and plainly, and still know it's going to get it.
And state your name.
Do the best you can.
Do the best you can.
And state your name.
Gotcha. Okay, I just want, for the record, there's been lots of social media out there, and because of legislation and the way we have to do the wording, it looks like that we are raising taxes, keeping the same rate as we kept as last year, which is the 48.3791. The proposed tax rate for this year is the same rate, 48.3791. We did not do the no new revenue rate because we all need EMS services, our public safety, our police officers. So we voted as a council to continue the same rate as 2023 as the 0.048.3791. However, it did increase our revenue by 2 million or so, but that was increased due to the property growth and the values in this town. We've grown, or the house population has grown by at least 950 housing in this community, and nobody is taking into consideration that the growth and the tax increase is due to the growth of our population. With that being said, I will make a motion.
Okay, 2.6 million. 2.6 million.
Yes.
Yes, 2.6 million.
So your motion is?
I move that the property tax rate be increased by the adoption of the tax of 0.483791.
Hold on. Number six. Oh, that'd be number six.
Sorry.
Okay. So basically, this is just a hearing,
right,
to be able to hear.
Right. It is. So we just need to close the public.
So,
gotta give them a minute to come up.
Yeah. So I'm going to open the public hearing on the tax increase. Open public hearing.
You've already opened it.
And for the fiscal year 2023. So I will now close the public hearing for the tax increase fiscal year 2023-2024.
We have to read it like that.
Trust me, there's a lot of confusion. So I have now closed the public hearing. Council, I know there's once more discussion. Mr. Thompson, you have a question?
Well, yeah, I understand this is the way it has to be read, but it says 1.9% increase in the tax rate. I thought it was 1.9% increase in revenue. Which is what it is.
Yes.
This is the way we have to state it because of the state rate.
Yes. So
just making sure that I understand.
Yeah. So this is a question right before we came up here. We were in the attorney's office. Stuff was in there.
5.2 increase in revenue. It's 1.9 difference between the no new revenue rate and the current rate.
Yes.
The new rate.
Yes. So it is 2.5, and then and when you get a percentage, 1.9. So I asked Seth if where is the chapter and verse that we have to do it this way, and so we pulled it.
Yeah.
We pulled the statute.
Right.
It specifically says
what we
the way it's written is how we have to say it.
We got to.
This is not home rule. This is not charter. This is not state. This is state law. And so I contested it too because I went in there because. Basically, I thought that we'd be able to say move the property tax rate and adoption up. And they said, no, we specifically, the state statute
says
you have to have that in there.
Yes.
Where it gets confusing, once again, is that because it is the same tax rate as last year,
right,
penny for penny,
right,
but because there is more inventory, it's more taxable,
it's increasing.
Real stuff. It's an increase of 2.5 million.
Hundreds of new homes.
If you remember, 2 years ago, we would have been talking, 4 years ago, we would have been talking about the effective rate.
Yes.
Yeah.
But that doesn't lend itself to the language. So the language now is you increase taxes because we have grown government revenue, so we've increased taxes. So that's why they're calling it a no new revenue.
And how we wind up assessing all of this is basically because we wind up, if you look at all the permits that are being filed and pulled, both residential and commercial, that is a quarterly report that you can see. And it is put out by our economic development. And if you start looking at it, you start seeing the time of how much more value there is in the last 12 months.
Mm-hmm.
And so, of course, it's going to increase revenue. But you know, after we get out of here, the only thing that's going to be looked
that is the word increase.
Well, basically what the change of language did is just allow our local media to be able to spend negative. That's all it's done.
Yeah, I mean, they're just gonna go off of them and they say we're gonna increase it, but the thing is, the reality is here is that penny for penny, we were adopting the 0.48371 just as last year, but there are increased revenues of 2.5, which looks we have more property that's being taxed. I don't know how more simply we can put it, but we'll you know what, we'll just get out there, we'll get on the radio, we'll go explain it and keep telling everybody.
Yeah, we can do.
How about a simple thing? We've grown by 5.2%, which has increased our tax revenue by 1.9 in revenue. Therefore, we have to announce that we technically it's not a tax increase, but it's an increase in revenue for us. And so, therefore, because the state says we need to word it like this, that's the way we have to word it.
Yeah.
So, but that's a real simple, easy
in actuality,
explanation.
That night, I responded to several through the mass media of social media, a response to critics outside of our community, some of the state legislature. I have no idea who these men and women are, as they wind up continuing to bash the council for the action that we took. And in actuality, the city of Odessa, the staff, council, the actual growth of city government was less than 1%.
Unlike the state. 25%.
Yeah. And that's the statement made. You know, the thing is, when you look at the growth of local city government was less than 1%, actually 0.77. That's less than 1%, and Mr. Brainmeyer's correct. Unlike the uncontrolled, huge growth that the state legislature passed of over 25%. And so I think those percentages are pretty good. I think that we were able to hold and mitigate it as much as we could. So it's a testament to the way that staff worked in the zero-based budget.
And Mayor, don't forget you got to close.
Yeah, I'll be closing the public hearing, which is item 4 for the tax increase of fiscal year 2023-2024. We're going to move on to item 5. Consider ratifying the property tax rate increase reflected to the fiscal year 2023-2024 annual budget. Mr. Bowles.
The Local Government Code, Chapter 102, Municipal Budget, Section 102.007, requires that adoption of a budget that will require raising more revenue from property taxes than in the previous year requires a separate vote of the City Council to ratify the property tax increase reflected in the budget. A vote under this subsection is in addition to and separate from the vote to adopt the budget, or a vote to set the tax rate, which is required by Chapter 26, the tax code, or any other law. The proposed rate is the same tax rate as approved for the 2022-2023 fiscal year. The rate will be 0.483791 cents per $100 valuation. The proposed rate is higher than the no new revenue rate of 0.474371, and it is lower than the total voter approval rate of 0.522978. This budget will raise more revenue from property taxes than last year's budget by an amount of $2,551,589, which is a 5.2% increase from last year's budget. And of that amount, $1,905,355 is tax revenue to be raised from new property added to the tax roll this year. The second and final vote on the proposed tax rate will now occur on September 28th, 2023. Does anyone have any questions on this item?
Council, any questions? Any action we have to take on this one?
I just need to ratify.
Just ratify?
Okay.
So we need a motion for item 5.
I move to ratify the property tax revenue increase reflected in the fiscal year 2023-24 annual budget.
We have a motion by Councilmember Monta. Do I have a second? Second by Councilmember Heen. All in favor indicating by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposing,
indicated by saying nay. Motion passes unanimously. We're going to move on to item six, consider levy tax for the 2023 tax year, fiscal year 2023-24. Ordinance, first approval. Set.
With this item, the City Council will levy the tax for the 2023 tax year by adopting a tax rate of 48.3791 cents per $100 property valuation for municipal maintenance, operations, and debt service for fiscal year 2023-2024. The proposed tax rate will remain the same as last year. The 2023 total taxable value for Odessa is $11,112,735,746. This is an increase of 5.2% as compared to the total 2022 taxable value. The second and final vote on this levy will occur now on September 28th, 2023. Does anyone have any questions for me on the item?
Councilor? So we will entertain a motion for item six.
So I move that the property tax rate be increased by the adoption of the tax of 0.48379, which is effectively a 1.9% increase in the tax rate.
I have a motion. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
I have a second by Councilmember Vasquez. All in favor indicating by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposing indicating by saying nay. Motion passes unanimously. We're going to move on to item seven, consider necessary signatures in connection with city funds. Set.
Mr. Mayor and Council, this item attached resolution provides a list of authorized signatures in connection with city funds. The list of authorized signatures is to be amended by adding the name John Beckmeyer and Monica Munoz and deleting Seth Bowles.
Council, discussion? If not, a motion. I have a motion by Councilmember Haney. Second.
Second
by Councilmember Mata. All in favor indicating by saying
aye. Aye.
All opposing indicating by saying nay. Motion passes unanimously. Seeing that there is no more business before this City Council, I have a motion to adjourn by Councilmember Schwartz. Second by Councilmember
Vasquez.